We're going to finish the integrative review for factoring on this video. We're going to do the last six problems. And again, remember, this is a great review because this is how the test will be, where they'll be mixed together and it won't tell you which format to use for which problem. Also remember, GCF should be your first step on every single problem. So I would start off by writing down GCF, honestly, in every single answer blank, so that you don't forget middle of the test to do that. So looking at number 34, it's a trinomial, and the leading coefficient's not a 1. There's no GCF. So again, you have a choice of doing this using trial and error, or you also can use the AC method. If you're going to use trial and error on this problem, remember that you would start off with thinking again that it would be 6y squared would be 3y times 2y. That at least eliminates a few of the choices. You do have a plus and a minus no matter what. So again, pause this, use whatever technique you're going to use. I'm going to show it on here using the AC method, because the trial and error method is, again, just plugging in, seeing if it works, and then trying another try. So in our chart, we're going to use 6 times negative 15, which is going to give me a negative 90. And my B is equal to a positive 1. Remember, my signs are positive and a negative. I want two numbers that multiply together to give me a negative 90, that when I multiply them, gives me negative 90, and I add them, I get a positive 1. So if you can see it right off the bat, that's great, but most of you can't. So remember, we start with the smallest number, which would be negative 1. Negative 2 goes into it 45 times. You'll have a calculator. That's not going to work. Negative 3 goes into it 30 times. That's going to give me a positive 27. That doesn't work. 4 does not divide into it. Negative 5 goes into it 18 times. That would give me a 13. That doesn't work. Negative 6 goes into it 15 times. That's going to give me a 9. That doesn't work. The next number that divides into it is negative 9. That one works. So that's how I'm going to split up my middle term. Always bring down the first, bring down the last. We're going to factor by grouping. So out of the first pair, I can pull out a 3y. Leaves me with 2y minus 3. Always bring your sign down. Out of the second pair, we can pull out a 5, which leaves me with 2y minus 3. These match, so those come down. Using the distributive property, we pull out the 2y minus 3, and what remains goes into the other parentheses. That is my answer. Now again, I would have done this problem using trial and error. I actually probably would have guessed this combination as my first guess. It might not have been the right signs, but I would have probably started off with 3y and 2y for the 6y squared. And I can't put a 3 in that first parenthesis. So my first guess for 15 would have been 5 and 3. So most of you would have been able to guess and check this one pretty quickly. All right, going on to number 35, our second problem for this video. Again, it's a trinomial. It's in the correct order. There's no GCF. My signs here will be a positive and a negative. Again, this is not a hard one to do with trial and error. Some of you may have to do two tries before you get the right one on this one, because you might start off with 2x times 2x. But once that one doesn't work, the next choice has got to be 4 and 1. The only choice for 5 is 5 and 1. So again, most of you will be able to do trial and error pretty quickly on this one. But I'm going to still do it on here using the AC method, just so that you have that if you're struggling. So 4 times negative 5 is negative 20. Two numbers that multiply to give me a negative 20, that when I add them, I get a negative 1. And most of you can see that that, off the top of your head, should have been a negative 5 times a positive 4. So we got a negative 5x plus 4x for my splitting of my terms. I'm going to underline. So first pair, I can pull out an x, leaves me a 4x minus 5. Second pair, I pull out a plus. If nothing comes out, always put a 1 as a placeholder. It's super confusing if you don't do that. So these match. They come down. what's left over, the x plus 1, goes into the other parentheses. Again, this was not a hard one to do as trial and error, and I probably, again, would have done it that way, but I want to keep showing you on this video the steps of how you would do it with the AC method, because trial and error, you would have just chosen. You would have started off with 5 times 1, since that number is prime. A lot of you might have tried 2x and 2x, which wouldn't have worked. So the next logical choice is 4 times 1. And so at the most, you would have had 3 tries to multiply out to see if it works. Going to 36, our third problem. This has got 2 terms. So first step we should still be looking at is there a GCF? And yes, there's a GCF on this one. We pull out an x, leaves me with x squared minus y squared. Now it is a difference of squares, so this is going to continue to factor to x minus y, x plus y. And again, it doesn't matter if the plus or the minus is first. So going to our last 3, and again, pause this at any time. It's a good idea to pause it and see if you can follow through on it. So number 46, our fourth problem here, if I was doing trial and error, it would be 7x and x, automatic. You place those down, and in my opinion, your first choice y'all would have chosen for 9y squared should have been 3y and 3y. If you guess and check that one, that actually is going to give you the correct answer. So the correct answer is 7x plus 3y times x plus 3y. That is the right answer. And to me, that would have been the logical first try, multiply it out and check it. But again, I'm going to do it real quick here using the AC method just so that you see this. They're both positives. 7 times 9 is 63. So I wanted to multiply to give me 63 and add up to give me 24. 1 times 63 doesn't work. 2 doesn't work. 3 goes into it 21 times. So 3 times 21 gives me the 24. That one works. So I'm going to split my middle term up into 3xy plus 21xy. Bring down the first term. Bring down the last term. And now I'm going to factor by grouping. So out of the first pair, I can pull out a x. Leaves me 7x plus 3y. Always bring your sign down. You can pull a 3 out, a 3y. Leaves me a 7x plus 2y. These match. Sorry, it should have been 7x plus 3y. That would have given me that piece. And I caught the mistake because they didn't match. So I caught that again. It's really important. So 7x plus 3y, x plus 3y, which is what the remainder goes into the other parentheses. And so if you use trial and error, awesome. Most of you will get that one correct on the first try. If you don't, it's okay. It just takes a little bit longer to do using the AC method. But I want to stress something real quick. On your work paper, if you are using the AC method, we have to see how did you come up with the combination that you split up your term. You can't just do all of these combinations in your head and keep them straight. So we expect to see some type of a chart, some type of a relationship that you've done to figure out that piece. So, you know, I need to see what are you using to come up with that. So going to our fifth problem, we have, in this case, 2 terms. It's a binomial. I personally would rewrite this because I like them to be in this descending order. But if you don't rewrite it, it's not going to be marked wrong. So I'm going to pull out a negative 1 to rewrite it as 8y cubed minus 125. Just change the order. If you didn't, you'll get an equivalent answer. It just will be in a different order. So that negative 1 stays. We get a binomial times a trinomial. This would be 2y minus 5. We need a 4y squared to get the 8y cubed. We need a 25 to get the 125. We multiply our first parentheses together, which gives us 10y, and we change our sign. Same sign, opposite sign, always positive. So that would be what I would use. If you left it in the order that they had it, you would have 5 minus 2y, and then 25 plus 4y squared plus 10y. This is the same answer. Okay. Only difference is that this first parenthesis is in a different order, and so that's pulling out the negative 1. Going to our last problem for this, again, it's a binomial. So, again, scan it. Can we pull out a GCF? No. So, if it helps, rewrite it. This is 4x. This is a 3. So, 4x plus 3, because we match our sign. We need a 16x squared to get the 64x cubed. We need a 9 to get the 27. Multiply the first parentheses together and change my sign. Same sign, opposite sign, always positive. Every one of these problems you can check. So this test, you need to get in the habit of knowing that before you press submit, you have checked them. But you have to show your work on your paper as well. We will not give you credit for this test if you just miraculously come up with how to split these middle terms and are not showing your work. Also, when you're just doing, again, trial and error, showing us that you're actually checking that it works. So you're not always going to get the first guess being correct. So we want to see that work and it needs to be organized. So show your work. When in doubt, put extra pieces down. No problems are going to be prime. You're always at least going to be able to pull out a GCF. And the more practice you do, the more comfortable you're going to be with this. And you have to be able to factor for test 4 as well. Good luck.